huh, Auntie Mary, give me fufu 10 cedis, willy 6 cedis, goat meat, apapo 12 cedis, and chicken thighs, fat one, 8 cedis.
Okay, right away.
Sauce keleke, payday is good. Add beer one wine.
In the hustle and bustle of life, retirement considerations
next year
are often relegated to the bottom of our collective financial agenda. Until retirement hits you unprepared, living on a meager retirement income can be traumatic and stressful, as you can no longer afford to live life the way you want.
Can I have fufu 50 pesos, goat meat 1 cedi, and chicken thighs small 50 pesos?
Hey, please, we don't sell our dunle and our chomo here. Oh. Go to the next store.
I do ya wow.
Hello and welcome to Money Talk, a live session on Facebook where we discuss various topics pertaining to personal finance and retirement planning. Remember that this program is proudly brought to you by Access Pension Trust, a private pension provider who has a mission to inspire you to achieve financial peace of mind through our retirement savings solutions and our financial literacy interventions. A few weeks ago, I announced that the Access Pension Plan now has a free life insurance cover of 5,000 Ghana cedis. You heard me right. To find more about this product and other products and services we have, kindly reach us on 0302-738-555. For the month of September and going forward, guess what? We are starting a new reward system for you, our loyal viewers. So from the month of September, we are going to be awarding on a weekly basis the 3 lucky viewers that are able to answer the question of the week, and every month we'll award the top fan, that is whoever comments and shares the most. So make sure you don't miss out on this one. But till then, remember to join us each and every Wednesday at 4 p.m. My name is Mimi and I'll be your host for today. So for the past few weeks, we've been discussing insurance, and I must say it has been an eye-opener. We started with understanding insurance, and then we took some time to focus on life insurance and non-life, or what we call general insurance. Today, we want to wrap it all up with a topic on the role of insurance in retirement planning. Remember to drop your questions and your comments in our comment section below, and we'll do well to have them answered before we leave this place. Today, we are very, very fortunate and privileged to have with us Mr. Emmanuel Akwada. He is the head of distribution for Hollard Life Assurance. Welcome, Mr. Akwada.
Thank you, Mimi. Thank you very much. And I'm very grateful for the opportunity given to me to be with you today.
My pleasure. Okay, so let's go straight to the topic for the day. Why must I consider insurance when planning for my retirement?
Okay, good question. When it comes to insurance and when you are looking at retirements, what some of us will also call pensions, these two things are, let me call them cousins, or they are quite related in one way or the other. Mm-hmm. If you take it from the perspective of insurance basically is looking at some unforeseen events in the future, which are likely to lead to reversal of your financial fortunes, better still, makes you financially worse off. So what insurance is seeking to do largely is to say that think into this future and then pick an insurance policy such that just in case you are so unfortunate to have suffered some of these unforeseen events, what the insurance will do is to come and cushion you, more like put you back to where you were just before the unfortunate event occurred. So that is like insurance, pretty much in the future. If you come to look at pensions or retirement, you are similarly talking about something which is also in the future. You are looking at a situation where someday, somehow, you will come out of work. You will not be able to work as you are doing now, especially for us, those who are in the formal space. You will not be able to have the strength to even continue, even if you are in the informal space. So you are thinking of something that you have to put aside to be able to cushion you whenever you come to the point where you are not too strong to do the rigorous things that you are doing as at this time. So both events are looking at something which is in the future. But because we are looking at the future and the future is unknown, then insurance becomes really necessary in order to take care of the uncertainties that will come along the way. Whilst you are thinking of putting aside monies for your old age, you don't know in the intervening space between 30 years and 60 years, between 40 and 60, between 25 and 60. That is a long journey to travel, filled with so many uncertainties. And because you cannot put a finger on the uncertainties, you need to put in place other contingency measures, such that in case an uncertainty strikes, you will be able to stand firm. And that is why we are recommending that since insurance is good at taking care of uncertainties, then it makes sense. And when you are planning for retirement, you consider insurance as well. So that is why it is essential that you factor in insurance.
Very interesting. Yes. One of such notes, what has happened that someone didn't expect. So that's an example of what you were talking about, where a number of people have lost their jobs. And exactly. So may or may not affect their retirement and planning process.
Yeah, you're right.
So how can insurance help me achieve a comfortable retirement?
Okay, so from what I've told you in my introductory remarks, mm-hmm. Once somebody is planning towards retirement, what basically you are doing, like I said, is that you are putting monies away so that your standard of living will not change just in case you hit your retirement. And mostly because you are planning a particular standard of living when you go on retirement, you are looking at what your normal expenses are like at the time you are working. And you don't want to reach your old age and then you are stifled as to how much you can spend. So normally people will plan their retirement looking at particular sums of money that they would wish that by the time they are in retirement, they can lay hands on. And that would give them the kind of comfort and maintain close to the standard of living that they are having now that they are working. But what I'm trying to put across here is that as you move in this life, and like I have mentioned in the beginning, you are traveling a long journey. There are people who you have interest in, and then they also have interest in you. They have interest in you because it is because of your existence that they have a livelihood. It is because of your existence that they can visit the hospital and get treatment. So a typical example is if I am a worker, an income earner, and I have my parents, and at the end of the month, I need to send some 500 Ghana cedis to an old man or an old lady somewhere. Or better still, if this my old man or this my old lady, if they are ill, I am called upon to come and help restore the situations, then you should think of the bigger picture. The bigger picture is that someday that old man will not live forever. That old lady will not live forever. Now, when they decide to say goodbye, there's a bigger expense that you must incur. The question is, where are you going to pick that bigger expense from? Is it this same money that you are planning for your retirement, which you are going in bits, growing it such that you think that the investment returns will help you to be able to meet the goal that you have set for yourself in retirement? Is it the same money that you are going to fall upon to try and take care of this eventuality. What we are saying is that no, whilst you are working and you have incomes, use insurance to take care of the possibility of you losing a father, the possibility of you losing a wife, the possibility of you losing a husband, or possibility of losing a mother. These things can happen. Beyond the issues of even death, there are cases where, unfortunately, you see people get ill, and then though it doesn't happen frequently, once in a while you hear a case where somebody has been diagnosed of cancer. And anything like cancer and the likes, when they step in the equation, they change the whole conversation. It could well mean that some contributions that you've been doing since you were 35 years, you've now traveled all the way to about 50 years. Good contributions ongoing, being invested prudently. But at that 50th year, where you are growing, no doubt, I have taken the planning properly. At that particular time, if you are called upon that a spouse has been diagnosed of cancer, what do you do? It means that if you don't take care, you would have to take this money that you have invested all these years to go and take care of a case like cancer. And that can erode the entire fortune that you have. So what we are saying is that if you think through things properly and you anticipate that these things can occur, then what you do immediately is to say that in case there's cancer along the way, what can I do? So you pick a policy, an insurance policy, that would promise you that in case you or a family member, somebody is diagnosed of cancer, we can come in and give you some money to help cushion that particular situation. When that happens, it means that you will not fall on the monies that you are planning for your retirement. Now, another example, young people, we start working, and the moment we start working, first, I mean, like you come from school, you start working, the first thing is to rent some place and then put your head. But life transitions from point to point. You get to a point in time, you want to get married, then you are moving from father's home into your own home. You start planning to build your house. And sometimes it takes you time. In as much as people are able to just get access to some good mortgages to buy a house, others too don't go through that route. Others have to build small. So there are people who is taking them 5 years. Others is taking them 10 years to be able to put up, say, a 3-bedroom house. Now, look at the journey you have had to travel, having to go maybe 5 to 10 years, small. Today, you get money, you go and buy small roofing sheet. And that time, you get money, you go and buy a small set of tiles. So you travel maybe 5 to 10 years before you finish completing the house. Can you imagine what life will be like in case one day this house gets gutted in fire and the whole house goes down? It means your whole life has been reversed 10 years back, if not more. Because circumstances would have changed, inflation has come in, so prices might have changed. So something that you did in 10 years, now you maybe need 15 years to be able to do it. What has happened to that retirement plan? Or what it means is that to start again, you may have to go and de-invest all these retirement funds that you are saving to be able to go and put up a new home. So you life would have treated you very unfairly. What we're saying is that if you think through things properly and you see that this can occur, that house that you have suffered so much to put up, you will quickly go and insure. And once you've insured it, you are saying that if something happens and then this house goes down, I'll fall on the insurance company to regain my house. I don't need to go and destroy the beautiful investment plans that I am currently doing. So it's a series of, I can give thousands of examples, but all I'm trying to drive at is that since the investment, the pension journey is not a 2-year journey, it's not a 3-year, but it can go as long as 20, 30 years. It means there's a lot that can happen within the intervening space. And then once you think of all the risks that can happen properly, the wisest thing to do is to find out which of these risks can I use insurance to take care of. And insurance can take care of a wide variety of risks, thankfully. So I'm sure any of them that you think of, you have insurance options to be able to use to take care of it. So that it doesn't derail your progress. It doesn't cause you to go 10 years backwards or 5 years backwards because you failed to take a particular plan. That is why insurance is necessary when you are planning for it.
Very, very interesting. And we do find ourselves sometimes with emergencies that cause us to come and take all the money that we had planned for something else, like our retirement.
Exactly.
I think it's very relatable. Before we continue, remember that this program is proudly brought to you by Access Pension Trust, Access Pension Trust is a private pension provider whose mission is to inspire you to achieve financial peace of mind through our retirement savings solutions and our financial literacy interventions. You can reach us on 0302-738-555, 0302-738-555 to find out more about our products and services. Okay, so Emmanuel, what are some of the types of insurance I need when I retire? We know that, you still have risks, so you are no more. So yeah. When you transition into insurance, what are some of the key insurance that you think a retiree will need when they retire? And why would they need that insurance?
Okay. Thank you very much, Mimi. Whenever you hit retirement, unfortunately, sometimes when you want to use the insurance options, it becomes a little bit tight on you. Just because it gets too expensive, it becomes very expensive. And that is why sometimes in our recommendations, we will tell you that, look, pick insurance when you are young. Unfortunately, the mindset is that insurance is for the elderly, people who are, who have quite a responsibility around them. That is not the case at all. Because before I come back to the main question, let me deal with this. When you are younger, insurance people will see you as one who is carrying lesser risk. Now, once you are carrying, we don't anticipate that a young person will die. So even if an insurance company promises a sum of money to be paid upon the death of a person, normally they anticipate that a young person, all things being equal, will live and live longer. So once that person doesn't have like underlying conditions in terms of health and everything, then we know you will live longer. So once you can live longer, then there's no need charging you more because your risk is less, you know. And it's similar to the pension conversation. When we say that if you are planning your pension, start early. Once you are starting early, you have a longer horizon to travel on. Because of that, you can invest small sums of money, and over a long term, you can build wealth for yourself. So is the insurance conversation. That start early. Because when you start early, your premiums are lower. Because the insurance companies don't see you as a risky person. But the moment you start getting older and older, then you are becoming riskier to the insurance pool. And once you are becoming riskier to the insurance pool, when you call for insurance, we'll ask you to pay more. So unfortunately, so when you hit retirement and you want to consider insurance options, one thing you should bear in mind is that insurance options could be slightly expensive than if you had taken them a lot more earlier. It's most advisable to start early and then you renew them. And that one, the premiums don't change. But when you start at a late time, we will rate you just when you are joining the pool. And at that time, because you are older, you pay more. But there are several of them that are crucial when you are in your retirement. One of them you can take, for example, is like a personal accident policy. In your old age, you are weaker. You may not be as sharp as the young guy who senses an emergency and then can jump off the scene and then be saved. An old person in an attempt to escape of an emergency, you can end up falling down, breaking your leg, breaking an ankle, breaking a bone. These things are what we call some form of disabilities in insurance. So we are saying that in your old age, one of the things you want to consider is more like a personal accident policy, so that in case you suffer any form of a disability, the insurance company will help you to take care of it. One of the things that happens when we are in our old age is that we incur a lot of medical bills. Unfortunately, so it is the majority of the case that when we are in our old age, we have medical expenses to take care of. So if you can get access to some kind of a health insurance policy, it is ideal, so that in case you have to visit the hospital for any form of a treatment, it is the health insurance policy that is going to pay the medical bills and not you yourself. Because at that time, you need that money to survive into the unforeseeable future. So you don't want to be paying frequent monies to the hospitals because of old age and its associated conditions. One of the things you can also pick when you are hit your old age is what we call a whole of life policy. A whole of life policy is one policy that you are telling the insurance company, look, I'm ready to pay premiums on my life till I die. And it is one of the wonderful ways you can use to create a legacy for your children. So if I want to live, say, 500,000 for my son or my grandson when I'm dead. I tell the insurance company, insure my life for 500,000 and then make my son the beneficiary. When I die someday, that son is able to comfortably continue life. But let me tell you one interesting one, which would interest you, the pension operators, and we, the insurance operators. Currently, what is happening is that there are discussions going on for annuities to come into the market space. That discussion has started at the insurance regulators level. They are holding this discussion with the pension regulators as well. Now, for those who may not know what annuities are, what it is that when you hit retirement, normally, be it that you have gotten some lump sum from your employer contributions or your personal contributions, there is some lump sum you have taken hold of. When you take hold of that lump sum, people can put that lump sum to different uses. What annuities are saying is that bring that lump sum to an insurance company or the pension company who, better say, the pension company who is running the annuity. So when you pay the lump sum to the pensions company, what the pension company is going to say is that based on this sum, we are promising that on a monthly basis, we'll pay you X amount, and we'll pay the X amount till you die. Now, the promise is definite. So let's say I go and deposit a 200,000 lump sum to Axis Pensions. Axis Pensions tells me that, Emmanuel, henceforth, because you brought us 200,000, you can be assured that every month we'll pay you 5,000 till you die. What can happen is that it could be that Axis Pension will pay me for the next 8 months and I die, and then the payment ceases. Or it could be that Axis Pensions will pay me for the next 30 years because I'm one of those people who is blessed with long life. So though I retired at 60 and I only gave 200,000, they are paying me even as at 90 years, they are still paying me. So there are chances in there. Now, what Axis Pensions normally will do is to also try and seek some kind of protection for themselves. So they also team up with the insurance companies, and the insurance company also brings some security. So the promise that Axis is giving to the pensioner, that promise is being backed up by the insurance company. So it just gives security for the future. So annuities are one of the things people must also consider. And like I said, it is coming up into the Ghanaian market space very soon. And the earlier ones I mentioned, if you have a house, some people don't complete their houses until they hit retirement. And then they pick their lump sum and then they go and finish their project and they go and live in. Now, if you have used your pension funds or part of it to go and finish a house to live in your old age, you don't want to leave any risk just lying unattended to. So quickly, the best thing you do is that house, you make sure you fully insure it. So if something happens to the insurance company, pushes you, else as an old man, you will die of heart attack. If you have a car, same thing, you want to make sure that car is not third party, it's comprehensive. Because third party, you are only compensating another person who you might have cause a damage to their property. And when it comes to you yourself, when you cause a damage to your vehicle, nobody will compensate you if you are having a third party. So it is ideal that you sign up to a comprehensive policy in your old age when you have hit pension. Said that any damage that comes, in fact, when you're an old man, you cannot be as sharp on the road as somebody who is young. So the maneuvering the young people will do, you cannot do same. So what it means is that you must make sure that you are adequately insured so that in case something happens, at least once you have life, the insurance company will restore the rest. And one of the things you do, take care of or take advantage of group policies. Group policies are cheap. They are normally cheap. So you are part of the pool. Your contribution to the pool is very small. But group policies can give a wide range of cover. And group policies are policies that involve both the young and the old. So what the insurance company really is charging you for, it's a mixture of the two groups of people. So the premium normally per head is not too high. So take advantage of any group policy you can find and be part of the pool. If something happens, your family members are safe because you have been able to leave behind a legacy. But as a retiree, the money you are bringing on the table in terms of your lump sum and then your monthly pensions is what you are using to take care of the family. You need to insure your life as well, to the tune that can make the family comfortable in case you die. So if you know that perhaps you are giving the family 2,000 cedis every month to keep the home going, you should insure your life to multiples of the 2,000. For For example, if I'm giving the home 2,000 every month and I've insured my life to 50,000, I have insured myself to about my calculations, maybe like multiples of the 2,000 I'm giving is what I've insured. That is over 25 months and beyond. So what it means is that in case I die, it doesn't bring a sudden shock. The family can still fall on the money that the insurance company will pay. They are able to continue life till they adjust to the reality that me, the supplier, am no more. By which time they would have put in place alternative measures to be able to continue life. So these are some of the ones that immediately will come to mind that I can mention as some of the policies you need to be thinking of when you hit retirement.
Thank you very much, Emmanuel. The final question is, as I announced, the Access Pension Plan now has a free insurance cover of 5,000 Ghana cedis. I want to know more about that feature and how do we benefit as members of the Access Pension Plan?
Okay, so let me first of all commend Access Pension Plan for such a wonderful thing you are doing for your clients. I mean, there are a lot of companies in the system, but it's one of those things that you rarely hear. For a company to take to say to themselves that, look, all the clients that we have, we're beyond what it is that we are investing for you for your future, we've still put in place a free life insurance cover. It's a beautiful thing you have done. But what it is that beyond death, it does not only cover death. The Access Pension Plan, the life insurance cover that Hollard is underwriting, does not take care of only death. It also takes care of total and permanent disability. So you may not need to necessarily be dead before you can benefit from that kind of an offer. In case you are alive, but out of an accident, you suffer a total and permanent disability, that money is also payable to you yourself because definitely you are alive. And an example of a total and permanent disability is a case where perhaps out of an accident, you have lost limbs. So once you've lost two limbs, it means you have lost the ability to walk on your own. And that is the case of a total permanent disability. And we are saying that when such instances occur, we'll still pay out the 5,000 that we have promised. But people are given the chance to increase such limits if they want to. But that one, I don't think Access will bear that cost. I'm thinking it's something that on their own, they can still talk to us. I'll talk to you and then we can get them increased coverage.
Yes, we'll be talking more about that additional information in the near future. Thank you very much. We have a question that has come, so I'll throw it to you. Are there special, I think you answered about still as though, are there special insurance prices for retirees?
Special insurance prices?
Yes, and this is by Bruce Amegashi.
Oh, okay. In fact, it's, well, what I've said already is the fact that once you hit retirement, means if you are picking an insurance policy, you are coming in as an older person. And once you are an elderly person, you have to pay more. And so it is not like a special price, but that is the principle that insurance works with. The younger you are, the lesser your premium, the older you are, the higher your premium. So it's not like special, but that is how we price insurance policies generally.
Okay. So there's another question from Johnson Amiku. He's asking, are insurance benefits in retirement paid together with pension benefits? So
insurance benefits paid together with pension benefits.
In retirement.
Yeah, it depends. It depends normally on the kind of policy that you have bought for yourself. Now, that said, let me mention this. There are certain types of policy which we call term policies. Term policies on the surface is to say that I work to an insurance company and I said, look, for the next 20 years, put on my life 100,000 Ghana cedis. In case I die within the 20-year period, pay the 100,000 Ghana cedis to Akosua, who is my daughter or something. So it is a term policy. The term under consideration is 20 years. So the contract is basically that the insurance company will tell them that, Emmanuel, for this 100,000 you are demanding, every month pay us 50 Ghana cedis. for the next 20 years. And the contract is that when you die, we will pay Akosua 100,000. But there are variations to the policy, that particular policy. The basic contract is that if the 20 years is due and I'm still alive, I go my way peacefully, the insurance company goes this way because that was the contract. Die within the 20 years, we pay 100,000. If you live after 20 years, we don't owe you. That's the basic contract. But over time, there are variations to that policy where some companies will say that despite the fact that this is the basic contract, we are still making room for some payout in case you finish the 20 years and you didn't die. So instead of saying, go your way and let's go away, we still can return something to you. It may not be the entire money you paid, but we can return something to you. In fact, in some advanced economies, you can have policies that will return the entire contributions to you. But I'm sure as the market expands, we'll get to the point where insurance companies will start offering some of these policies on the market. So if you put it that way, then you can say that, look, if somebody is looking at pension planning and the person has taken like a term policy on the side, which has a cash out, then you can hit pension. And once you are taking your pension lump sum, you still have some cash out on the term policy that you took. So when we get to that stage where those types of policies are available, then you can say yes to the question the listener or the viewer has asked. But now, the kind of policy we have on the market, I cannot say of a certainty that we have those sort of policies here.
Okay, thank you. So there's another question from Nana Dora, but I think I would have to answer the question. It's asking about the Axis pension plan, whether we pay a lump sum or we pay monthly pension. So the Axis pension plan normally pays a lump sum. However, upon retirement, if you think you need us to help you in managing your lump sum, we can have a further discussion. But what we normally do is pay a lump sum. So thank you so much, Mr. Emmanuel Fada, for joining us. We've learned so much this August about insurance, and I was told that it's the insurance month, right? For the nation or something. Yeah. So we've learned so much about insurance, and we hope to use whatever knowledge we've learned to ensure that our financial plan is more holistic. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us. We've had such a wonderful session. I personally have learned so much. I hope you've learned so much too. For the month of September, we'll be doing some throwbacks. We've done a number of financial or personal finance and retirement planning discussions. We want to go back and relook at them and learn more. If you have any questions that were unanswered or you have any new questions, remember to ask that in the month of September. Also remember that the reward system starts next week. We are going to be rewarding 3 lucky viewers who are able to answer the question of the week. So make sure you don't miss out. And we are also going to be giving an award to the top fan for the month. So make sure you are sharing, make sure you are commenting so that you don't allow that award to walk away. So thank you so much once again for joining me. Till next week, stay safe. And if you need to call, I just remember it's 0302-738-555. 0302-738-555. Stay safe and have a wonderful day.
Do you know that your retirement will come much sooner than you think? Retirement is a crucial stage in life that should not be taken for granted. The absence of a monthly salary during retirement reinforces the need for retirement planning. So how are you planning for retirement? The Axis Pension team helped me to set my retirement goals, take my financial inventory, assess my retirement prospects, evaluate my financial situation, set my pension plan in motion, and review and monitor my retirement planning progress.
Oh,
Daddy.
Oi, huh?
I want to eat pizza.
You will eat a go fruit. Go and ask your mother.
Visit accesspension.com. Access Pension Trust, your reliable partner in pensions.